Has this happened to you? You left your keys somewhere and you can't find them. You walk into a room and you don't know why you went in there in the first place. Are these the first signs of dementia? In this video, we'll examine natural ways to prevent dementia. Coming up. Right. Unfortunately, there are no disease-modifying drugs to stop progressive dementia or to cure the disease. However, the good news is that there are certain steps you can do, ideally early on, to live a healthy life. There are different types of dementia, the most common type being Alzheimer's dementia, making up about 70% of the dementia cases. In Alzheimer's dementia, there is an abnormal build of proteins in brain cells and around brain cells. These proteins are neurotoxic, meaning they cause damage to the brain cells. One of the proteins involved is called amyloid, deposits of which form plaques around brain cells. The other protein is called tau, deposits of which form tangles within brain cells. As brain cells become affected, there's also a decrease in chemical messengers, they're also called neurotransmitters, involved in sending messages or signals between brain cells. This damage interferes with the ability of brain cells to communicate with each other. When brain cells cannot communicate normally, normal everyday actions which you and I take for granted are affected, such as thinking, behavior, and feelings. This is because particular regions in the brain are damaged. Alzheimer's disease usually first damages the hippocampus, leading to memory loss and disorientation. It later affects areas in the cerebral cortex responsible for language, reasoning, and social behavior. So that means when cells in a particular region are damaged, that region cannot carry out its functions normally. So bringing up the earlier example of losing keys. So if we have a key and we place it on a table, we are using a certain part of the brain which is located in the temporal lobe. And it's called the temporal lobe because it's located near the temple. And the temporal lobe is used for short-term memory. So if we leave the key, we know we have to pay attention because we leave the key and the temporal lobe is using it for storage for short-term memory. Then there's also the frontal lobe, and the frontal lobe is located in the front of the brain. And that tells us where we're sitting. So I'm sitting here, and I know I'm here because of the frontal lobe sitting here in my home. And there's a communication between the temporal lobe and also the frontal lobe. However, in Alzheimer's dementia, there's damage to the part of the brain, which I said, the hippocampus in the area of the temporal lobe. And if that's damaged in terms of short-term memory, there's also no communication to the front part of the brain, the frontal lobe. So you leave your keys in a place, there's no sort of short-term memory to help you remember where the keys are. And in terms of communication with the frontal lobe, that's also damaged and you also don't know where it is. So if you're interested in a video looking at medication that can slow the progression of Alzheimer's disease, click on the link provided. It's normal to occasionally forget recent events, such as where the keys were last placed or the name of the person you just met, especially if you're not paying attention in terms of short-term memory to be formed. However, if it is consistent affecting your quality of life and you are unable to formulate a plan to retrace your steps, it is a problem worth looking into more carefully. So what are five things you can do to prevent dementia? Number one, exercise. Exercise has many known benefits, reducing the risk of cardiovascular disease and diabetes, strengthening the muscles and bones. Moreover, physical activity seems to help your brain not only by increasing the blood to the brain, but also by increasing chemicals that protect the brain and raising your good cholesterol called HDL cholesterol. When we age, there is a natural reduction in brain connections. Exercise can also lead to formation of new brain synapses and protect the brain cells from dying. In a study by Dr. Baker, she's a professor from Wake Forest School of Medicine, she concluded that 6 months of aerobic exercise is sufficient to favorably move tau protein levels in all adults at a higher risk of progression to dementia. There was a statistically significant reduction in the aerobic exercise group in their spinal fluid of tau protein. So how much exercise should we do? Exercising several times, 3 to 4 times a week for 30 to 60 minutes, such exercises as walking, jogging, cycling, dancing. Dancing is aerobic and it also provides a mental challenge of remembering dance steps, hand and eye coordination and balance. According to the WHO, at least 150 minutes of moderate physical activity per week, including strength training, yields not just physical benefits, but cognitive ones as well. The next thing you can do is blood pressure control. Let me give you two examples of studies or opinions regarding this. The American Heart Association and the American Stroke Association concluded that blood pressure lowering to lower the risk of post-stroke dementia is effective and that it's reasonable to lower blood pressure in midlife to lower the risk of late life dementia. In the New England Journal of Medicine research based on Framingham Heart Study examined the potential role that cardiovascular health, including blood pressure, plays in dementia. The study did show improvements in dementia rates, however, only in participants who had a high school diploma. The findings showed that earlier diagnosis and more effective treatment of stroke and heart disease likely contributed to a lower incidence of dementia. If you're finding value in this video, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that notification button. Third point is cognitive training. When looking at population studies, these show that education increases cognitive reserve. In the earlier study, you mentioned the Framingham study that found that participants with at least a high school diploma benefited the most from declining dementia rates compared with participants with less education. So what would I advise to activate our brain cells? Learn a new skill. Pursue learning a new language. Actively read crossword puzzles. For example, a study of nearly 2,000 cognitively normal adults, 70 and older, found that participating in games and crafts and computer use and social activities for about 4 years was associated with a lower risk of mild cognitive impairment. The next thing you can do in terms of reducing dementia naturally is diet. According to the World Health Organization, WHO, they examined several population studies and recommend a Mediterranean diet, which is high in fish, fruits, nuts, and vegetables, as this was associated with lower rates of dementia. Then there is the so-called MIND diet, a combination of the Mediterranean diet and the DASH diet, dietary approaches to stop hypertension. This was a diet heavy in leafy green and vegetables. Nuts, berries, beans, whole grains, fish, poultry, olive oil, and wine in moderation. Their diets were limited in red meat, butter, cheese, sweets, fried, and fast food. Another thing you can do to reduce dementia naturally is sleep. You can look at sleep. In a 2015 study looking at sleep and associated amyloid plaques in brain regions reported, and I quote, that self-reported sleep quality, but not quantity, was associated with amyloid plaques in brain regions typically affected in Alzheimer's dementia. This just means that the participants in the study who reported sleeping problems had a higher association of amyloid plaques. There are also other theories that speculate that toxic substances like the aforementioned tau proteins and amyloid plaques are simply washed away with better quality sleep. So looking at these studies, poor sleep, insomnia appear to be risk factors for Alzheimer's dementia. Another thing you can do in terms of naturally reducing dementia is a combination of this. My general recommendation would be a combination of recommendation talked about earlier in this video, in a recent study in neurology looked at five behaviors. They were associated with a lower risk for Alzheimer's disease. The five behaviors were not smoking, consistent moderate physical activity, light to moderate alcohol consumption, a high quality Mediterranean style diet, and engagement in late life cognitively challenging activity. So, question of the day: what are you going to change going forward to reduce your risk of Alzheimer's dementia? Leave your answers and comments in the section below. And if you want to see more videos and subscribe to this channel, click right here or here, here, here. Thank you and goodbye. Of a dementia, which is not blah, blah, blah. Okay. Good.